Good morning from the Piermont Bridge. I am taking a walk today just to exercise, really. It's a long weekend. It's Australia Day tomorrow, and Monday is an off day for us. I think there's going to be an event here that they're going to close the bridge because there's railings on there. Anyways, so here you see there's like a few people, just a few. Still quite quiet. I guess it's already only 7:30 in the morning, but the sun's already quite high. So the idea is to walk over Harbour Bridge over to the Calibria Markets, and then depending on what I get from there, take the bus home. But like, look at that sky. The city is looking a little bit dead. Well, there's people around, but it's not as busy as the usual weekday, obviously. Normally you've got a lot of people there waiting for the bus. Okay, so I'm taking a different route to the one that I took when I went cycling over to the Kirribilli Markets. This time I'm going through Cumberland Street so that I could actually pass by the side of the Sydney Opera House and show you guys what that looks like. It's a really balmy, cloudy, 25 degrees Celsius day here in Sydney. And I can already see the Harbour Bridge from here, right there. That's where we're gonna go on and walk and enjoy the view. Just passed by the Shangri-La. I'm still walking on Cumberland Street. There's a bed and breakfast here called the Sydney Harbour Bed and Breakfast. Some old structures next to new structures. And look at this car. Oh, look at that other car too. This is actually the first time that I've been through this part of the rocks area, and I really need to explore Sydney a little bit more because there's a lot of like beautiful places around that I haven't been to, and I do have quite a bit of time in my hand, so there's really no excuse. I mean, just look at how pretty this neighborhood is. Oh, it's a neighborhood for the like the rich families. For you to be able to afford rent over here, you need to be making probably at least $125,000 a year. That's for single income. Okay, here we go. It says Cahill Express walkway closed on Sunday, the 26th of January. That's tomorrow. I can still go up. This is the bridge stairs. Cyclists are not permitted on the path. Use cycleway, which is on the other side. Okay, it's a good thing that I decided to come up here then. It's a little bit creepy. It's like one of those horror stories or horror movies where the protagonist walks up the stairs to the unknown, only to find death waiting at the top. How morbid. Yeah, Cahill Walk, Sydney Harbour Bridge. But had I walked further, I would have discovered that there was an elevator instead of climbing up three flights of stairs. That's okay though. I need the exercise anyway. But just FYI, if you have difficulty with accessibility, there's always elevators around, or here in Sydney it's called lifts. And here we are, the Harbour Bridge, and you can see a lot of cars. On the other side is where the trains go. And I think it's going to be closed tomorrow because it's Australia Day. I'm not sure if there's going to be any fireworks given the bushfires around Australia. there were already a lot of people who were complaining about the New Year's fireworks while the fires were raging in different parts of the country. This view though. So there's like cruise ships docked at Circular Quay, and there's the Sydney Opera House. So there's the Opera House, and then down here is the Park Hyatt. Planning on booking high tea there and just watching the ferry boats cross over in front of the Opera House. So I was trying to find out, while the railings and these things are in an angle, and apparently there have been people who's tried to jump off the bridge, so they've had to make it much more difficult for them to actually climb on top of the railings by making that into an angle. And by the way, this is what it's like to stand under the harbor bridge. Okay, I'm home and I've just washed all of the clothes that I got from the Kirribilli market. Now, the money that I used to buy these clothes is the money that I got from selling some of my clothes that I don't use at that shop called Swap in Newtown. I got about $58.75, and all of these five items are $45. These four here are $10 each, and then this dress right here is $5 at the Kirribilli market. So today was a good day at the markets. Actually, these four things here were bought from the same shop. They have a shop there that's like everything is $10. So this one here is a Basque blazer that is sort of like a peachy pink shade. I don't know if that's the one that's being captured on camera, but it also looks like this is one that you don't need to iron. I'm probably gonna try and steam some of the creases out. But this is going to be perfect for work. Another work blazer that I got, this is Zara Basic. This is in the size M. This one is in the size 8, which is usually a size too small for me, but I tried it on and it was fine. A bit tight on the arms, but that's okay because this is actually a blazer that I would use more in the summer, so I wouldn't be wearing thick clothing. I probably will be wearing sleeveless dress underneath this. Okay, yeah, so this one is the Zara one. The reason why I went to Kirribilli market is because I wanted to get a beige or a light brown blazer, and this one is perfect for that. Obviously needs a bit of ironing. There we go. And it's fully lined, which is something that I like. Now they've cut off the tags on here, so I don't actually know what it's made of. This one, I believe, is polyester. Unfortunately. Yeah, polyester, and elastane. But I believe this is going to stay quite a long time in my closet, so hopefully that makes up for it. This one is a beautiful dress. It's got a bow. This is by Forever New. It's size 10. It doesn't look like it's even been used. I forgot to remove the tag of this pair of trousers, so it actually put some like white stuff on the dress, but nothing that a lint remover can't take. But I just fell in love with a bow, and this one again looks like it doesn't need to be ironed. There's a little bit of creasing, but I can definitely work with that. This one, what is the material of this dress? Let me just go ahead and check. So I figured it's polyester, that's why it doesn't need ironing. Okay, this one, I actually own a taupe version of this. This one is more like the military green, kind of olive. It's from the same brand called Vadim. Yeah, and it's also XL, so that's why I know that it fits me, because my taupe one is XL. And this is the one that had a tag on, and it sort of like disintegrated in the wash, and I had to pick out all the white stuff from this one. And then this dress here, oops, okay, this dress is by Basque. This is actually a really good brand of clothing here in Australia. Let me just try and fix this. Okay, and they were selling this for $5, which what I thought was a pretty good steal. Size 10, which is my normal size. Okay, hopefully that doesn't slip off. Okay, size 10, my normal size. There's like a fabric sticker on here so that it doesn't show too much cleavage. Cinches in the waist. And I think this is also polyester. Yeah, so these have just been washed, and throughout the whole time that I was talking about this, you would have seen me with cutaways of what they look like on me. So that was a pretty productive workwear hunt. So, yep. Before I forget, there's another thing, and I'm watching Alex on iCovetti, and she's opening some packages, and I realized that I haven't shown you this. I ordered a replica on DHgate because I wanted to see what that was about, and I think this is the first new thing that I had purchased in a long time. I ordered this back in December just before Christmas, but it didn't arrive until yesterday, which was the 24th of January. It was meant to arrive on the day of my birthday. But anyway, as you can see, it's an Yves Saint Laurent. Rive Gauche branding. I've already taken it out of its outer packaging. So it came in sort of like a packet with some sort of like foam around it so that it protects the item. Now this was $27, which translates to about 35 to 40 Australian dollars. So obviously it's a replica. Now I didn't expect to actually come in a box. I thought it was just gonna come as is. And I also most definitely did not expect it to have a dust bag. So there is nothing else in the box other than this. And this is actually a card holder because my current card holder is almost ready to give up. I ordered this one because I really like the black on black. You can see it's actually quite pretty, and it's a matte black. Pretty well made. This is in caviar leather, which is very similar to the type of material that is used on my Chanel replica that I got secondhand off of Facebook. So there you go. Now it also came with a authenticity card. Obviously it's a fake authenticity card. How weird is that? This certificate of authenticity guarantees, and as you can see, it's misspelt. It's supposed to be TWES, guarantees your Eve, and that's supposed to be a vet, okay, a V. What did I say vet? A V. So YVES, Saint Laurent product against all manufacturing defects. Okay. The French wording is correct, but this one is not. And even the word this has got B instead of an H. Okay, so I wouldn't be showing this off to anyone. Yeah, but it's there if that's something that you care about. Anyway, I know that this is a replica, so I'm not really that fussed about it. But it's a really nice material. It's pretty good. There's some like, I don't know if you can see that. I changed position so maybe that you can see it better with the lighting. But yeah, there. See, that's better. See, there's still some red spots. This is like, I think it's just dirt. Okay. There's none here. In the front here, there's none of that either. Another dust there. So this one's pretty clean. There you go. But here, actually, when you open it, it actually has Saint Laurent Paris on there. Okay. But on the other side of it, it's not. Well, you can also tell from here where it's been glued that it's sort of like unraveling. And this part here also has those red bits. I've got black leather paint, so I'm just gonna paint over that. But yeah, pretty much how it is. The bottom side, the actual sides, yep, and the top section. So whatever it is that needs to get painted with black paint, I'm just gonna go ahead and paint it myself so that it looks nice. I'm actually feeling quite accomplished today because after that 5 kilometer walk to Kiribilli Markets across the Harbor Bridge, and after thrifting $45 worth, 5 items of workwear, when I came home, the first thing that I did was actually clean the bathroom, like thoroughly clean the bathroom, brush the floors and everything. Not just, you know, spritz, but really put your elbow in it. I think that's the term. And then after that, I also, while I was doing that, the clothes that I got from the Kiribilli Markets were being washed. And then I vacuumed and then I washed the floors afterwards. So it's, and then I also polished our leather sofa. So yeah, feeling quite accomplished. And then I wasn't even done with that. I then took out some of my clothes that needed ironing and I ironed them because I was thinking, you know what? It's gonna be my first day of work on the 3rd of Feb. I need to have my clothes ready. I don't wanna be ironing my clothes on the day or the day before. So I have time right now. It's the long weekend. Let me get that out of the way. So I did that too. And yeah, I feel pretty accomplished. I think I'm gonna end the vlog here because there's nothing else that's really gonna happen today. I don't know what I'm gonna do tomorrow. Tomorrow is Sunday. So yeah, I'll end the vlog here. And there's a bus passing by. I'll see you all again in the next video. Let me know what kind of videos you want to see. I am definitely planning on a few styling videos, like the one that I posted where I have one dress and I'm styling it 5 different ways. If that's something that you want to see, let me know in the comment section down below. I'm also planning on Pinterest inspired styling, not necessarily like buying whatever it is on Pinterest, but finding something in my wardrobe that's similar if not the same, and then using that to copy a Pinterest outfit that I like. So those are the two main things that I'm thinking of doing at the moment so that I can start really like going through my wardrobe, seeing what clothes I really like, which ones I reach for, which ones I can actually style and I feel good in. And then hopefully at the end of every season, I would take a look at the season past and see which ones I didn't end up using and maybe bring that to a home that would, you know, give it more love than I do. Oh, by the way, as I am filming this, the clothing swap that I am participating in over on Instagram is currently happening, and I've got 2 of my items already swapped. My brown Mimco bag has been swapped for a fairly new pair of Bali flats, so I'm pretty chuffed for that. I'm gonna do a video of what that clothing swap was about and who organized it and what I got out of it and what I am swapping. The other thing that I've already swapped, confirmed, is my faux Burberry laptop bag that I am swapping for a vintage polka dot dress, maxi dress. So I'm very excited to receive that in the mail because I hear polka dot is going to be a big trend in 2020. And since I'm not using the laptop bag anyways, I thought that it would go to a better home where it's actually going to get used. So yeah, I was saying goodbye, but then I thought of other stuff to say. So now I'm definitely saying goodbye. I'll see you all again in the next video. Bye.